Where is Magic Design in Canva? Has Magic Design moved? Yes and no, but don't worry, in this quick video, I'll share where Magic Design lives now and how to find it and use it. This is a Where in Canva video, where I help you find features or tools which may have changed or moved in Canva so you can get your work done more efficiently. I'm Donna Moritz, Aussie Canva Verified Expert and top template creator for Canva. Let's do this. Magic Design has had a little upgrade, and that involves some slight differences in how to find it, especially for Magic Design for images. Other than that, my original video here still has some great tutorials and demos. I'll add the link to this video and in the description. It walks you through how to use Magic Design for images, as well as Magic Design for videos and presentations, which have largely not changed. Previously, you would add your prompt on the home page for Magic Design to create a selection of templates for you based on your prompt. You could add media here for design options using your selected image. All of that is still possible, but the place to begin has changed. There are now two ways to find Magic Design for images. Number one, you want to go to Canva AI in the side panel, and then we're going to ask it to design for me. So add your prompt, Instagram post about tips for solo female travelers, then hit enter, and Canva will create a series of templates or designs based on actual templates within Canva. So then all we have to do is wait for these to render and choose one that we like. Interact with Canva AI by clicking the plus button to add media. And then ask it to generate some more options. Again, it will give me solo female traveler designs using my image, and I can choose one that I like. I can also add images from Canva AI. So again, I'm going to get it to design for me, click the plus button, and then choose my image. Now Canva will again use AI to create a series of designs or templates featuring this image. You'll notice that the finished designs that Canva produces pull in colors from the background of the image, which is a neat feature. Then of course I can edit with Canva or even apply my own brand colors. The second way to access Magic Design for images is to go to canva.com/magic-design. This website works in a similar way. It's part of Canva, so you just come in here and add your prompt. You can see there's lots of examples here, and Canva will again go and create the designs based on your prompt. Canva will generate a series of choices, and then all you need to do is choose one that you like, and you can start editing in the Canva editor. It's an overview of the upgraded Magic Design, including extra tips on creating presentations with Magic Design, which I included in my original video, tips for video editing, and other handy features like applying your brand to your design. Using this landing page is a really quick and easy way to jump into Magic Design, so add it to your toolkit. Other than Magic Design for images, everything else is pretty much the same when it comes to Magic Design for presentations and Magic Design for video. So be sure to check out my original tutorial if you haven't had a chance. It walks you through everything. Magic Design is free for all Canva users, but you are limited in the number of credits you get on a free plan. Currently, it's 50 credits a month at the time of this recording, and you get 150 credits if you're on a Pro or a Teams account. If you want to take Canva Pro for a spin, you can do so on my free trial as a Canva Verified Expert. Use the link on the screen or in the description, sociallysorted.com.au/Canva, to access all of Canva's features, elements, and more. If you like this video, please subscribe and ring the bell. It helps me create more content for you. And be sure to watch the next quick tip video in this series. I'll add it on the screen for you. Stay creative.